So I want to talk a little bit about Watch Dogs 2. Watch Dogs 2 comes out November 15th, and that's not too far from right now when I'm recording this video. Watch some of the gameplay that's out there, and I'm thinking that this could potentially be a pretty decent game. And I really didn't like the first Watch Dogs game. I don't think that many people did, for obvious reasons. It was just kind of lackluster. It was kind of underwhelming. It was, I don't know, it just didn't really do what I thought it was going to do, And here with Watch Dogs 2, like I said, I've been watching the gameplay and the trailers and this, that, and the other, and it seems like it has potential. I mean, it seems like there is potential for, a great game to be in there somewhere. For example, it seems like in Watch Dogs 2 you can kind of like hack everything, whereas in the first Watch Dogs game you were kind of like restricted on what you could hack, and you're kind of confined, and I just thought that was kind of silly, in a game that like focuses on, hacking everything and taking control and, this, that, and the other. It's like, well, I can't hack this car over here, so it's like, well, this is kind of stupid and silly, But here in Watch Dogs 2, at least from what I've seen, you can just basically hack about anything, which is pretty cool. And Watch Dogs 2, again, at least from what I've seen, seems like it has an actual personality. It seems like they have. I mean, they know what they're doing with this game. I mean, I'm not saying they didn't know what they were doing with the first Watch Dogs game, but when you go back and you look at the characters and the story and, the setting, it just looks so dull and bland in comparison to what's going on here in Watch Dogs 2, And I think that's really going to, I mean, it just seems like Watch Dogs 2 has an identity. It seems like they had, this clear vision on where they were taking, Watch Dogs 2. And again, when you compare to Watch Dogs 1, it's like, it's almost a night and day difference. So it's like one game doesn't have a direction, the other game does, Some other things that I've noticed is, well, I don't know, to be honest with you guys. Like it does seem kind of similar to the first game in just terms of how things work and how the game looks. But that's okay because I think, one more thing I want to talk about real quick is the setting. The setting is, this time you're in San Francisco as opposed to Chicago. And listen, I'm from Chicago, and when a game takes place in Chicago, I get kind of excited. And I'm not really from Chicago, but I'm nearby. And I don't know, I just feel like they dropped the ball in the first Watch Dogs game with Chicago, or their version of Chicago anyway. It just really didn't do the game any favors, I don't think. I mean, it was an interesting, setting, but I think taking Watch Dogs to San Francisco is the appropriate choice. And I think there's, it seems way more diverse. It seems like there's more things to do, and yeah, So yeah, I'm looking forward to Watch Dogs 2 overall. I know this was kind of pointless, but I just wanted to give you guys my thoughts before we head into my like little review that I'm gonna do on November 15th, or a few days after that date. But you do have to keep in mind that, this is a Ubisoft game, and usually with their games, you have to be like cautiously optimistic about their games, because if you go in, expecting like this to be the best game ever, then you might very well end up be, you might very well be disappointed, when the game releases, when the game hits the store shelves. But yeah, I just wanted to come on here and talk a little bit about Watch Dogs 2 today. I guess if I had to say something, nitpick a little bit already, I'd say the audio, some of the audio from the game doesn't sound all that convincing. Like the gunshots kind of sound weak, and I think that was a problem with the first Watch Dogs game as well. I remember playing the first Watch Dogs game, and I remember just the audio not sounding right. It sounded like the cars would just, I don't know, the audio just. And that's the thing. It's like no one really cares about audio these days. It's all about visuals and animations and, this, that, and the other. And it's like, okay, cool. But what about the audio? If it doesn't sound right, then it's just not going to sound, I can't get immersed into this world, into this experience, if the audio is off. And that's one of the things that I think plagued the first game, among many things, is that the audio, at least from what I played, maybe they patched it up or something like that, but from what I played when the game first came out, Watch Dogs 1, the audio just wasn't, like I said, it didn't sound right. And the car sounds would just like rev up inappropriately, and it just didn't match with like how fast you're, like, that's just an example. Anyway, that's I guess one thing I could say in terms of what I think could be improved upon right now. But again, I don't know what I was watching. Like, the gameplay that I was watching probably wasn't from the final build, so who knows. But come back if you guys are interested. Come back on November 15th, and I will give you guys my full, like, in-depth, I guess, first impressions, whatever you want to call it, Watch Dogs 2 review. So hope to see you soon. Take care.